If you're an architect working in early stage concept, you're probably using Rhino for its speedy modeling capabilities. And in a perfect world, you would stay in Rhino forever, right? That's my dream anyway. But Rhino does fall short when it comes to documentation and scheduling. And this is where you might start sending your geometry to your Revit guys to create plans and sections. This is a common workflow problem we hear from architects, and it's something I've actually experienced myself. Your Revit team can't use the generic models that usually come from Rhino, having to rebuild the model with complex parametric families. So how do you bridge this gap without losing Rhino's modeling advantages? With Speckle, you can supercharge your Rhino geometry to automatically become categorized drift shapes inside Revit. So you can properly schedule, filter, and section your conceptual models, plus a whole bunch of additional benefits that come along with using Speckle in your workflows. So, in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to map your Rhino model for Revit and the best practices around that. How to load your geometry into Revit, and finally, some of those sweet, sweet additional Speckle benefits I mentioned before. Okay, let's get to it. First, you need your Speckle connector for Rhino installed. If you haven't already got this, you can sign up for free and download the connector via the link below. If you installed it and it's not showing up yet, just type Speckle into Rhino's command bar and it should appear for you. Speckle connectors are how we connect our favorite applications back to the Speckle servers. Here I have an example of a conceptual architectural model, and I'm wanting to send this to my colleague who's working in Revit. So we need to go through and tell Speckle what each object is so that it can go ahead and tell Revit what category to place those objects into. Now you've got a couple of ways to do this. Either select them manually, and this is what I would actually recommend, set up dedicated layers in Rhino for each category, like walls or windows. This will mean that mapping those objects will be a lot faster in the long run, because anything placed into that layer will automatically be mapped to the right category. It also just makes for a much clearer model for anyone else working on it. Your colleagues will definitely thank you. So, once we have all the layers mapped to the right categories, all we have to do now is publish this model to Speckle. You'll need to set up a project and name for your model. You can kind of sort of think of projects like folders you might have on your computer that contain various models relating to that project. Once your model is done processing and uploading, it will be accessible to anyone you choose to invite to that project via the Speckle web application. Now that you have mapped those layers and published your first version, you can make some changes to the model in Rhino, and when you go to publish again, Speckle will know what Revit categories to map them to. Not only that, but Speckle will actually notify your colleague in real time when a new version is available, so your Revit colleague gets live updates without having to export a single file or notify them of a new version. That's pretty nifty, huh? Now, over in Revit land, we will need to make sure we have the Speckle connector installed as well. Links down below to download that. If you don't see the Speckle connector panel, you can launch it from the Speckle tab in the Revit ribbon. Now, before we load in, I really recommend you create a dedicated workset for Speckle geometry. This keeps your imported and native Revit elements clearly separated. Whatever workset you have active at the time of loading your Speckle geometry is the workset it will become a part of. So now we're all set. Loading in is very simple. Just find your project and the model you want from the Speckle connector. That'll load the Rhino model into Revit, and because we spent some time setting up our layers in Rhino, Speckle will automatically convert the geometry to categorized drift shapes. This means you can section, filter, and schedule these objects in meaningful ways. So that's all cool and all, but what's the potential use case here? Well, you might need to create a plan that has furniture filtered out. Normally, this wouldn't be so straightforward if you were working with generic models. But because we now have categorized direct shapes, we can see we can easily set up a plan and filter out that furniture. So this means you can now keep developing your conceptual models in Rhino while still getting meaningful drawings and schedules from Revit. Because Speckle is a live service, this is not just limited to you jumping between Rhino and Revit on your local computer. You can have team members that have never used Revit able to meaningfully deliver to your Revit team. It also works bidirectionally. You can actually start modeling in Revit for elements like columns and publish those to your Speckle project, enabling your Rhino colleague to load your Revit geometry with BIM data intact. Now, there are some alternatives out there, like Rhino inside Revit and Dynamo, but these will require technical expertise and are local only, so not all of your team is going to be able to interface with it easily. Speckle connects your favorite AEC applications, letting teams work asynchronously, publish exactly what you want to share with live version notifications, and collaborate with anyone worldwide through the Speckle web viewer. Get started for free at app.speckle.systems and see how it transforms your workflow. All right, that's it for me. See you in the next video, and happy speckling.